Bulisa district. Here is more.
The contract has been awarded to Mota Ingen, Uganda, and works expected to be completed by June 2022.
We have been doing a lot of studying, a lot of engagement. Today we have entered a critical phase where the project is really taking off. As I've said, major commitments are being made on a major contract. We're talking of multi-billion dollar investments. It means we need all to work together, all the stakeholders, okay? We need a lot of support from government, and this is why you see the Petroleum Authority owns this project. We need support from all stakeholders yourselves. We need to be able to understand that there will be ramp up in terms of the organization. So, whereas you see just a handful of us here, to deliver a project of this magnitude in order of billions, you will see lots more people being hired on this project to be able to deliver it.
Due to the need to protect the environment, only 31 wells out of the 400 that were found with commercial quantities shall be operational to feed the central processing facility.
After the crude oil has been refined and we have our diesel, our petrol, our kerosene and the like, it will be transported. It won't be distributed from there. People won't go to buy at the refinery. It will be transported to Mpiji. They said Namuabula in Fiji, and then will be the distribution center. So that's why we have the crude pipeline and the products pipeline. They shouldn't be confused. You can't use the same pipeline for crude oil and for products.
Crude oil will be transported from the central processing facility to the refinery in Kabale before being exported through the East African crude oil pipeline in Tanga.
There will be a central processing facility, and then there will be infield pipelines, these small yellow lines, about 180 kilometers. And then the crude oil will be collected at this central processing facility in pink, and then transported by feeder pipeline. So this black line is a feeder pipeline that will go up to Kabale, where we were yesterday.
Processed oil will be taken through Mpiji district for distribution to other parts of the country. According to Uganda National Oil Company Limited, Uganda has invested 15% of all the money into the oil industry. Story by Ismail Kasoha for the news in Bulisa district.
Let's head to Jinja, where an electronics shop and a car belonging to two Indians have been set ablaze by an unknown gang that has been targeting the Indian community in Jinja. Police, however, say there is no need for panicking.